Hello, my students. Welcome. Today we're going to learn about computer. It is going to be a Form 1 class. It's going to be about areas where computers are being used in our daily life. So before we start our lesson, we have to at least sanitize ourselves. Remember to keep safe, keep social distance at home. The first area we're going to discuss is supermarkets. This is one of the areas we see computers being used. So computers are being used in supermarkets. In the supermarket, you know, they're used to serve customers. Another one, they're being used to monitor and control the stock levels. They can be able to see when they are being used in the supermarket, they are able to see which stock has run out and which one needs to be restocked. So that's one of the areas the computers are being used in supermarkets. Other areas whereby you have seen computer being used is in banks. Banks is another second place where we see computers being used. In banks, computers are being used to dispense cash. They're being used as machines, what we call the ATMs. They're being used in banks, and at the same time, they can be used to keep the records of the bank's customers and their clients. So there's another area whereby you have already seen computers being used. Maybe look at the third place where computers are being used. It can be used in transport. Transport. So in transport, computers are being used there to control traffic in major towns in our place. You know, they're being used to control the traffic lights. So that's the other areas where we have seen the computers being used. That is the third area where we have seen computers being used. I think we're going to move to the fourth area where computers are being used again. The fourth one is going to be hospitals. Hospitals. I think majority of us have ever visited the hospital, either directly, either being sick, or we've ever taken there a patient. So computers in hospital, they're being used to keep records of the patients and also to keep the treatment history of those patients. And also they're being used when they are serving the patient when they are being admitted, so they keep their records there. So these are some of the areas where we see computers being used. But as the, now of late, again, computers being used in hospitals, maybe either to facilitate oxygen. When you are trying to use special machines, when someone is having difficulties in breathing, they normally use special machines to provide oxygen for those who cannot breathe directly. These are some of the areas where you have seen computers being used. The fifth area whereby we see computers being used are in industries. Especially in most developed countries, we see computers being used there, but in an advanced way, whereby we see they used machines like robots in trying to control and facilitate industrial processes. In areas, especially areas which are not good, they're not conducive for a normal human being to be operating those areas. It can either be at high temperatures, whereby it may not be that favorable for a common human being to be there. So they prefer using the machines, which can be subject to maybe to hostile conditions. Other areas is communication. Communication is another area you have seen computers being used. So, in communication, computers are being connected either through normal cables or through Wi-Fi or through the internet, whereby there's transmission and the sharing of resources. Through this, they've been able to reduce the world into a global village, because someone from maybe a different continent can be able to send the message to a different person, to a person on a different continent at the same time, or someone in a different country can be able to send that information to another person, a different country too. So this one has really facilitated and has really made communication to be more efficient and quick, because there's no movement of letters, which used to take a lot of time when sending the message. Other areas where you have seen computers being used are in law enforcement. So this is whereby they keep our fingerprints and images, maybe our physical, maybe the eyes, because people are different. The genetic makeup of a person is different from another one. So once you go to the law enforcement areas, when you're taking maybe an ID, you normally take your fingerprint. That fingerprint is stored, it is kept in their records. So in case someone commits a crime, it is very easy to trace the crime scene, the signs or the fingerprints which are found in the crime scene with what they have in their data bank. So once, with them comparing what has been found in the crime scene and what they have in their data bank, it is easy for them to either to trace the person who has really committed that crime. That one is one of the easiest way to trace people, in case maybe something has been done somewhere. So, and the next one we have seen computers being used is in education. In education, they're being used in, like in what we are doing now, we are facilitating what you call computer learning, computer aided learning, whereby we are facilitating this information through computers, with the combination of other device to pass the knowledge. So through this, you have seen computer being used. And other areas, in computers, in education, computer has a wider scope, whereby it can either be used for transmission of the content or retrieving content online. So some of us, you know, of late, you are accessing maybe the revision materials through online. Maybe you are being sent some learning materials or revision materials through WhatsApp or through other means that are available. Other areas where we have seen computers being used in education is by what we call computer-aided cards also, whereby some of the content that is being taught in class and cannot be easily interpreted. So what is being done there is that we use things like in practicals, especially in practicals that involves maybe the sciences. Instead of us doing that practical in a lab, we can simulate that practical in a way that we project that practical by the use of what we call special programs that is able to do the same of what a normal teacher could have done in a lab. And once we have been taken through that program, it is easy for us to do the practicals on our own, even without maybe the teacher being present, as long as we have the materials with us. The other area is domestic and entertainment. Domestic use and entertainment. So, like now, I know the majority of you. So, like I know the majority of you at home, you have computers which can be able to use either for keeping your own personal things. Also, you can be able to use computers at home to play games, watch movies, listen to music. Those are some of the few things that you can be able to use computers at home. And lastly, entertainment, we know, we can use computers either to entertain ourselves through music, whereby we know nowadays the DJs, they combine the help of the use of computers to perform or to facilitate the entertainment industries. So those are some of the areas where we have seen computers can be used in our daily life. And this brings us to the end of our lesson today.